ವಿಪಾಸಿತ ಇಂದ್ರಾಣಿ ಇಂದ್ರಯಾನಿ ಪರಮತಿನಿ ಹರಾತಿ ಪ್ರಸಬ ಮನ. ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಲೇಷನ್ ವೈಷ್ಣವಿ, ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯು ಗೋ ಅಪ್ ಲಿಟಲ್ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್? ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು. ದ ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸೋ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಆಂಡ್ impotence, O Arjuna, that they forcibly carry away the mind even of a man of discrimination who is endeavoring to control them. Purport. There are many learned sages, philosophers and transcendentalists who try to conquer the senses, but in spite of their endeavors, even the greatest of them sometimes fall victim to material sense enjoyment due to the agitated mind. Even Vishwamitra, a great sage and perfect yogi, was misled by Menaka into sex enjoyment. Although the yogi was enduring possessed control with several types of penance and yoga practice. And of course, there are so many similar instances in the history of the world. Therefore, it is very difficult to control the mind and senses without being fully Krishna conscious. Without engaging the mind of Krishna, one cannot see such material engagement. A practical example is given by Sri Yamunacharya, a great saint and devotee, who says, "Et advanti mama sheta Krishna padaravinde nava nava rasa danmaye udyatham rantham aste tad avanti bato nari sangama samayubmane bhavati mukta vikara sustan nishvansa." Since many mind has been engaged in the service of the lotus feet of Lord Krishna, and I have been enjoying an even new transcendental humor, whenever I think of sex life with the women, my face at once turns from it, and I spite at the thought. Krishna consciousness is such a transcendentally nice thing that automatically material enjoyment became distasteful. It is as if a hungry man has satisfied his hunger by a sufficient quantity of nourishes eatables. Maharaja Abharishi also conferred a great yogi, Durvasa Muni, simply because his mind was engaged in Krishna consciousness. Sava Maha Krishna Pada Ravindrayor Vamsamsi Vaikunda Gunavarnani. Hare Krishna.
Yes. Okay, so we should understand what's happening here. That, remember, Arjuna was thinking about giving up work and going to the forest. So Lord Krishna is warning him what can happen when you try to go away to the forest. And when you try to give up work and go away to the forest, then you're left with the mind and senses. And if your mind is not perfectly controlled, then the senses will drag you away and you have problems. So it's a very dangerous thing to do, to go away from the world and try to renounce and give up everything, unless one is very prepared. And one has to prepare for that by practicing controlling the mind and senses. Right? It describes here, the senses are so strong and impetuous, Arjuna. Which sense is the strongest? Ramya Mariji, do you remember? Of all the senses, which one is the most difficult to control?
Tongue.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah, the tongue is the most difficult to control. So the senses are very strong and they can carry away the mind even of a man of discrimination. I mean, someone's got some good intelligence, and he's endeavoring to control them. Prabhupada gives an example in the purport about Vishwamitra, who was a great sage, but he had problems. He got problems. Of course, what happened was Indra was worried that Vishwamitra is becoming so powerful that he wanted to cause his fall down. So Indra personally arranged that this woman, Menaka, came. And Menaka was very, very attractive. She's coming from the heavenly planets. So she attracted the mind of Vishwamitra. Although he was in the mountains, away from the world, he'd gone away from the world and he was in the mountains doing austerity. But when he saw the beautiful woman, he became attracted and he forgot everything. So this, Prabhupada said, this is not unique, but there are many cases like this in the world. Many similar instances in the history of the world. It's not an easy thing to control the mind and the senses. So Krishna's warning Arjuna of the danger of giving up work. Arjuna may think that if he gives up work and goes away from the world, he will be safe. But Krishna is saying, well, it's very dangerous. There's a lot of things can happen. So then Prabhupada quotes about Yamunacharya. Yamunacharya, he was previously, he was the head priest in the Sri Rangam temple. He's from the Sri Vaishnavas, Yamunacharya. And he was senior to Ramanujacharya. So Yamunacharya, before he became a devotee, before he became a great saint, previously he'd been a king. He'd been a ruler and he had a palace and he had so much opulence. So he was surrounded by many of the fair sex. So he'd enjoyed material life a lot. He'd had a lot of experience of the material world. But afterwards, later on in his life, he left it all behind and he took to the devotional path and he became a great devotee. So he composed this verse where he describes the mind. And, you know, naturally, because he'd had a lot of experience of the material world, sometimes he would remember his past activities. And he would feel very bad about it and very guilty, and it would cause him to spit. So just like one devotee, there was one devotee, he came to Prabhupada and he was saying to Prabhupada, he said, when he chants Hare Krishna, sometimes within his mind, he can remember his life before he became a devotee. And he could remember different bad habits which he had before becoming a devotee. So he asked Prabhupada, why does Krishna allow me to remember these things which I did before? He said, I'm trying to chant Hare Krishna and I want to remember Krishna, but sometimes these thoughts of my past come in my mind. So Prabhupada explained to him, he said, yes, he said, Krishna is telling you that if you ever give up chanting Hare Krishna, then you'll go back to these things. He's warning you. But you better keep chanting Hare Krishna. Be careful. Don't fall back again. Don't go back to those things. But if you ever give up the chanting, you'll go back into that life again. And you'll have to go back into all these sinful, bad habits. You won't do yourself any good. So be very careful to always chant Hare Krishna and remember Krishna. And then Prabhupada also quotes about Maharaj Ambarish. Maharaj Ambarish, how he conquered Durvasa Muni. Of course, Maharaj Ambarish, he was a devotee who practiced all the different kinds of devotional service. And he would do everything. Prabhupada quotes a verse from the Srimad Bhagavatam. Right? Savaimana Krishna Padaravindayor Vachamsi Vaikuntha Gunarnuvarnane. Right? That he fixed his mind on the lotus feet of Krishna. And then Vachamsi Vaikuntha Gunarnuvarnane. He used his tongue to describe the wonderful qualities of Vaikuntha, the spiritual world. And this way he kept all of his senses. And the verse goes on, if you read Srimad Bhagavatam, it goes on to describe his other activities, how he used his hands to clean the temple, and he used his legs to walk to the holy places, and he used his tongue to taste the tulsi leaves offered to the Lord, and he used his nose to smell the flowers offered to the Lord, and he used his eyes to see the beauty of the deities. Like this, all of his senses were engaged in the service of Krishna. So because he was so absorbed in Krishna consciousness, when he was threatened by great yogi Durvasa Muni, Durvasa was envious of Maharaj Ambarish, that Durvasa Muni couldn't do any harm to him. Durvasa Muni tried to give trouble to him, but Durvasa Muni got trouble himself. And he ended up having to come to Maharaj Ambarish and ask for forgiveness. So it's a nice purport. Prabhupada mentions a lot of things there. Anybody has any questions about this?
Guru Maharaj, did Vishwamitra Muni fall down because he was practicing Ashtanga Yoga and not devotional service? Is it like that? Or
Well, Prabhupada does give that example, that Vishwamitra was engaged in meditation, silent meditation. But Haridas Thakur, in contrast, he says Haridas Thakur was also tested. There was a case when Maya personified came before Haridas Thakur and tried to take Haridas Thakur away from the chanting of Hare Krishna. And then there was another case where a woman came, a woman who was actually more of a prostitute, and she'd come with the intention of seducing Haridas Thakur. And she was saying that now he's chanting Hare Krishna, but in a little while he'll be chanting my name. But what happened was, Haridas Thakur told her, oh yes, just wait. When I finish chanting, I will enjoy with you. And so she waited and waited, and she had to wait a couple of nights. And after 2 nights of hearing Haridas Thakur chant, she also changed and she became a devotee and she gave up everything. And so Haridas Thakur, he didn't become a victim, but Vishwamitra became a victim because he was engaged in that kind of meditation. He didn't have a real hold, his mind was not fully focused on the Lord, right? We don't know where he was, what he was meditating on, but Haridas Thakur was meditating, he was hearing the holy name of the Lord, and he was associating with the Lord through his chanting, so he was not attracted. But Vishwamitra may have been doing impersonal meditation, meditating on some void, and so he got attracted and he fell a victim. So yes, the superiority of the bhakti yoga process over the impersonal process is shown by that example.
Thank you, Guru Maharaj. But Guru Maharaj, Bharata Maharaj also fell down, right? Guru Maharaj with a deer attracted. He got attracted with a deer because he didn't have association of devotees like that.
Right, because he didn't have association, and he became careless and he gave up his sadhana. His meditation was more on the deer than on the holy than on the Lord. So his sadhana became affected because of his affection for that animal. So Srila Prabhupada warns, you have to be very careful. You keep some animal like that, we get these things, we become very attached to material things. We take away all of our attention. So at the time of death, we're simply thinking of that. We're simply thinking about our material thought. We're thinking about our dog or our cat. He was here, a deer. Maybe you're thinking about your car, your home. It's the same thing. You come back. So we have to fix the mind on Krishna. We have to be careful not to keep these kind of attachments in the mind, because at the time of death, it will be revealed and will bring us back. Right? The test is coming at the end of life. When we have to leave the body, what are we going to remember? Where is our mind going to be? So we have to practice now in this life. We have to prepare so that at the end of life, we can think of Krishna.
Yes, Guru Maharaj. Some children ask me, if they keep a cow, then if they remember the cow, then they will become a cow in their next life or something like that. They ask me when I said this dear example, because all the children, they want a dog. So I told them we should keep a cow like that.
Well, at least the cow, yeah, there's no harm to, the point is, you see, we don't keep dogs, we shouldn't bring them in the house. We have it, it's all right to have dogs, but don't keep them in the house, you know, let them stay outside. But that's difficult in your, where you're living. In Switzerland, probably you're not allowed to do that. It's so cold at night there, dog would freeze. And so keeping cows is very good, but you have to be very careful also. Don't become overly affectionate with them. We have to understand they're animals. And you keep a cow, they can do service for Krishna. It's good to protect cows.
But because if you get attached, you can take birth as a cow.
Yes, that's true.
Isn't it?
Yeah, if you become attached to them, yeah. So we have to understand they're also spirit souls. You have to give them the holy name. And you can help them also do service for Krishna. Let them give some milk, which can be offered to Krishna. Of course, it's a lot of work to keep cows. But it's a very pious thing to do. Keeping cows, that's the business of the Vaishya. Farming, keep cows and farm. Cow protection, we should protect the cows. Of course, you need to have proper place to keep cows. You need to have land. And you have to be able to have grass to feed the cow. I think they have quite a few cows in Switzerland, isn't there?
Yes, Guru Maharaj. There are a lot of land, green grass. The cows are happy here. That's what they say. Yeah, of course.
In the winter, they must bring them in. They don't leave them outside in the cold, right? They'll bring them in the barn.
Yes, Guru Maharaj. There are some farms also. Yeah, there are a lot of cows in
Switzerland. And they have to keep the grass, keep the hay to feed them all winter.
The milk is also so pure in Switzerland, Gurudev.
Really? Oh.
Yes. Because because my daughter had gone there, and early morning they bring a big glass of milk in the hotel. It's not diluted with water, nothing. So pure.
Oh,
so I was so amazed. Yes.
Yes, Switzerland is famous for that because they have the mountains, they have the grass there, and the cows will be big. They give, can give a lot of milk. Very nice. This planet belongs to the cows, you know? The deity of this planet is Bhumi. And Bhumi, of course, is in the form of the cow. So this planet belongs to the cows. And we're meant to live together, the humans and the cows. The cows need us to take care of them. But we also need the cow because we get the most valuable food, milk. And from milk, you can make yogurt, and then you can make ghee. And with ghee, then you can do yagya.
Sweets.
Hmm?
We make sweets also with milk.
Yeah, we make a lot of milk sweets, right. Very. And Krishna loves the milk products. You know, Krishna likes milk and yogurt.
Yes.
We offer milk sweets to Krishna every day.
I have a question, Gurudev. Now, supposing if anybody has a pet in the house, any type of pet, and if you feed prasad to the pet, what will happen in his next birth? Will he get a human body? Or
if you feed prasad to the...
If he's in a devotee family, because if he's in a devotee family, and
yes,
if you're chanting, if he hears chanting, and when you do the aarti, if they keep on listening to the aarti, then that's all, you know, blessings for the animal, no?
Oh, yeah. Yes, very good. Yeah, the animal is very fortunate. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, one of the great, yes, devotee acharyas, he's written a song. He said, let me become a dog in the home of a devotee. Let me be a dog or even an insect in the home of the devotee. Because then I will be able, yes, to hear the holy name and I'll be able to get remnants of prasada. Yeah. There's a story. Yes. There's a story how there was one rat which was living in the temple. And so in the temple, they were burning ghee lamps. They would, yes, burn the ghee lamps. And this rat had the habit to come and eat the ghee. He'd come and he liked the ghee from the oil lamps. And so it happened one day he came and he ate the wick. He ate the wick, but somehow that wick was still on fire and it burned his mouth. And he began to dance in pain, you know, the pain of the ghee, burning ghee in his mouth. He set his whole mouth on fire and he was jumping in pain. And the deity thought, oh, this mouse is dancing for me. So the mouse died, the rat, it died. And next life, he got a very good birth. He became a brahmana or something, or became a princess, the daughter of a king, and he became a very great devotee and went back to Godhead very quickly.
Also, Gurudev, the other day, when I was doing the evening aarti, Gaur aarti, there was a small fly, the size of, I can't tell you, you know, very small fly. It had just come near the lamp. And it got burnt. It died while doing the aarti. Half burnt. Oh. And I took him and I threw him off. So what will happen to that? His soul? Will he get a human body? Or...
Well, certainly you get some elevation, get a good elevation, may get human birth, yeah. Hmm. Very auspicious, huh?
Yes.
Not ordinary. Anyway, that story is there about the rat that became the princess. So if the fly also died with the aarti lamp, we don't know. Next life must be very good.
Yes. Because Sindhu Mataji also told us a story that during the Damodar month, while a rat had come to the temple or a devotee's house, and while he was jumping around, his tail caught fire. And then he was going round and round. So in Krishna's eyes, Damodara's eyes, he thought it's a, he accepted it as an arti, as a Damodara arti, as an offering. And then later he went to a higher planet. I do something like that, she said.
Yeah. But that's performing devotional service unknowingly. So it's not pure devotional service, it's bhakti abhas, right? It's like a shadow of pure devotion. Yes. Just like some people chant the holy name, but they don't chant purely. They may chant jokingly, they may chant mockingly, but somehow they're chanting. In the Chaitanya Charitamrita, it describes that a Muslim, when he's gored by a boar, he says, Haram. So he's saying Ram. So he gets the benefit of chanting the holy name. So he gets liberation. He gets freed of sinful reactions. Okay, Bill, go ahead.
Yes, Guru Maharaj. Hema Mataji, can you please read this 2.261?
Yes.
Tani Shravani Samyamya Yukta Asita Mat Praha Vasihi Yas Yandir Yani Tasya Prajana Pratistita. Translation: one who restrains his senses, keeping them under full control, and fixes his consciousness upon me, is known as a man of state intelligence. Purport. Okay, thank you. That the highest conception of yoga performance is Krishna consciousness is clearly explained in the verse. And unless one is Krishna conscious, it is not at all possible to control the senses. As stated above, the great sage Dhruva Muni picked a quarrel with Maharaj Abhirisha, and Dhruva Muni unnecessarily became angry out of pride and therefore could not check his senses. On the other hand, the king, although not a powerful of yogi as the sage, but the devotee of the Lord, silently tolerated all the sages' injustice and thereby emerged victorious. The king was able to control his senses because of the following qualifications as mentioned in the Srimad Bhagavatam 9.4.18.20.
Savaimana Krishna Padaravindayor Vachamsi Vaikuntha Gunarnavarnane Karo Harir Mandira Marjanadishu Shrutim Chakarachuta Sadkatodaye Makunda Lingalaya Darshanadrisho Tadvritya Gatra Sparshinga Sangamam Granam Chatatpada Saroja Sorabe Srimatalashya Rasanam Tadarpite Pado Hare Shetra Padanuv Sarpane Siro Rishikesha Pada Bivandane Kamam Chadashyet Natu Kama Kamyaya Yatutama Shloka Janashraya Rati.
King Ambarisha fixed his mind on the lotus feet of Lord Krishna, engaged his words in describing the abode of the Lord. His hands is cleansing the temple of the Lord. His ears is hearing the pastimes of Lord. His eyes is seeing the form of the Lord. His body is touching the body of the devotee. His nostrils is smelling the flavor of the flowers offered to the lotus feet of the Lord. His tongue is tasting the tulsi leaves offered to him. His legs is traveling to the holy place where his temple is situated. His head is offering obeisances unto the Lord, and his desires is fulfilling the desires of the Lord. All these qualifications made him fit to become a mat para devotee of the Lord. The word mat para is most significant in this connection. How one can become mat para is described in the life of Maharaj Ambarishi. Srila Baladev Vidya Bhushana is a great scholar and acharya in the line of the mat para. Remarks: mat bhakti prabha vena shravendriya vijaya purvika savatma drishit su labhit bhavaya. The senses can be completely controlled only by the strength of devotional service of Krishna. Also, the example of fire is sometimes given. As a blazing fire burns everything within a room, Lord Vishnu, situated in the heart of the yogi, burns up all kinds of impurities. The Yoga Shruta also prescribed meditation on Vishnu and not meditation on the word. The so-called yogas, how meditate on sometimes other than the Vishnu from simply waste their time in the vain search after some phantasmagoria. We live to be Krishna consciousness, devoted to the personality of Godhead. This is the aim of the real yoga. Hare Krishna.
Okay, so Prabhupada is explaining, is it continuing to expand on the story between Maharaj Ambarish and Durvasa Muni? And he's explaining all the activities, as I just mentioned, about Maharaj Ambarish. And then Prabhupada talks about this word matpara. Matpara meaning in relationship to the Lord. So it's very important that we do activities which are in relationship to Krishna. That's important. If we want to control the mind and senses, then we have to connect to Krishna. And so he gives the example, the blazing fire. The fire burns everything within the room. So Lord Vishnu in the heart burns up all the impurities. But we could say, well, Lord Vishnu, isn't he in everyone's heart? Yes, well, he is, but we have to remember him. Right? We have to fix our mind on him. And in this way, when we fix our mind on him, then this will allow the impurities which are there in the heart to be removed. Just like the fire, when there's a fire, everything in the room gets burned. So in the same way, when we remember Lord Vishnu, then all the nonsense things, the bad things, they're all burned up, they're all removed. So then Prabhupada talks about the Yoga Sutras, because the Yoga Sutras is sometimes popular. It's Patanjali who wrote the Yoga Sutra. And in the Yoga Sutra, some people, they think that Yoga Sutra meditation is on something void. But Prabhupada said, no, it shouldn't. Meditation means to meditate on form, on a person, and the person to be meditated on is Vishnu. So the yogi should meditate on the Lord in the heart. The Lord in the heart has a form. And when we meditate on that form of the Lord, then that will remove all the impurities. Prabhupada says, so-called yogis, they meditate on something else. They don't meditate on Vishnu. They're just wasting their time. And they're not going to go anywhere. They're not going to get any good result. But Krishna conscious person, his meditation will be on the Lord. We have to fix the mind on the Lord. And then the impurities, then the heart becomes purified. Of course, we fix the mind on the Lord by Sankirtan. We do the chanting of the holy name. That's the power of the holy name, that it cleanses the heart, takes away all the impurities from the heart. So our meditation is mantra meditation, not the silent meditation, but mantra meditation. And the powerful chanting of the holy name, the louder we chant, the more powerful it becomes. So we don't just keep the, it's not some private secret mantra which we keep for ourselves, but it's shared with everyone. Everyone benefits by hearing the mantra. So this is the practical process of meditation for this age. Sitting silently is very difficult because the mind is never silent. The mind has so many thoughts there. It's very difficult to fix the mind. Therefore, we see the example of Maharaj Ambarish using all the senses, using everything for the service of Krishna. Okay. Any question, comment?
Hare Krishna, Maharaj.
Hare Krishna.
Maharaj, let's say a person is seriously chanting his minimum 16 rounds, but he's not offering food to the Lord. How does that work? But he's chanting seriously. Is he still eating sin?
Yes, because you eat food which is prepared by maybe you're taking food. I don't know. Is it food you somebody prepared for you, or you prepared yourself? If we say he prepared the food himself, then that's better. But if you take food which is cooked by non-devotees, then it's not very good. Because the non-devotees who cook, they don't have the consciousness of cooking for Krishna. But if you cook for yourself, even though you didn't offer it, at least when you're cooking, you can understand within your mind that you're cooking for Krishna, and that it's all Krishna's and meant for Krishna. And the offering process is important, because Krishna takes away any karma which is there in the food. Without offering the food, even though it's vegetarian, there'll be some karma. And if the food is prepared by non-devotees, there'll be more karma. So we want to eat food which is without sin. Therefore, they said yagna shishta. Yagna shishta means the offering. The food which is offered in sacrifice, that means the offering itself. That's the yagna shishta. We eat food which is first of all offered in sacrifice. And in that way we get relief from sin. But if we don't offer the food, then there's going to be some traces of karma there. Even though we may be vegetarian, it's vegetarian. But there has to be some recognition of Krishna. Maybe the offering doesn't have to be elaborate. you know, everything according to time and place and circumstances. Now, sometimes you have more time to make a proper offer. Other time you may be outside. How can you offer everything? At least within our mind, we should think of Krishna and we should pray to Krishna. And sometimes, you know, people would simply say, Sri Vishnu, Sri Vishnu, Sri Vishnu. Simply by remembering the name of the Lord, in this way they make a, you know, a kind of offering to the Lord. You know, before drinking a glass of water, maybe we would say Sri Vishnu, Sri Vishnu, Sri Vishnu, like that. It's a, you know, it's not a proper offering, but in some ways it's showing the respect and remembrance of the Lord, that this is the Lord's mercy. So we want to have some kind of consciousness. And Prabhupada taught us that even if the food is offered, then before we take the food, we would recite the prayer, the you know, Bengali prayer, the Sharira Vijajao. And so this kind of prayer, this takes away the material conception. Because the problem with taking food is, you know, we have a bodily conception, a material conception, and we think, well, this food is not spiritual. This is just, you know, I just eat it for my body to keep me healthy. I like the taste. And, you know, so to take away that kind of trace of material consciousness, we would recite that prayer. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur had written in Bengali that of all the senses, this material body is a lump of ignorance. No, all the senses, the tongue is most voracious and difficult to control. It's very difficult to conquer over the tongue in this world. But you, dear Lord Krishna, are so kind. You have given us this nice prasadam. So now let us take this prasadam to our full satisfaction and by so doing glorify the Lordship Sri Sri Radha and Krishna. Like this, the reciting these prayers, even that you say it in the mind, you know, it's very powerful and it takes away any of the material conceptions which we may have in honoring prasadam. Everything depends on the attitude. So the attitude is very important, that we understand that this food is Krishna's mercy. It's given to us by the grace of Krishna. And we want to take that food. We don't just simply eat, but we honor prasadam. Right? So try to take it in full consciousness. Even you may be outside, but the internal consciousness is important, the thinking of Krishna. So sometimes before you take the food, you can chant the Hare Krishna mantra 3 times, like that. Yeah, of course, people are working and you have difficult, sometimes you're outside, you have to eat. So time and circumstances, you have to consider everything, but try to keep the consciousness of Krishna. Is that all right? What do you think?
Yes, Maharaj. Thank you so much, Maharaj. Hare Krishna.
Yes, Gurudev, even these Ayurveda doctors, they also, when they give you medicine, they offer to Vishnu first. And then they give you.
Yes.
Yes.
So when you take medicine, yeah, we should also say Sri Vishnu, Sri Vishnu, Sri Vishnu.
I keep it on the altar. Some blessings.
You keep it on the altar. Krishna also has to take the medicine.
No, for his blessings, Gurudev.
For his blessings. Okay.
Guru Maharaj, can we take roasted peanuts from the shop? Does only grains carry karma or I had a doubt because here we get only roasted peanuts. They roast in the sunflower oil and they sell it in the shop like that.
Yes. So you roasted peanuts, they're already fried. You can also offer them.
So does it also carry karma, Guru Maharaj? The vegetables, the nuts, or only the grains carry karma?
Well, yes, some karma there in everything, but especially in the grains. You know, we don't take grains cooked by non-devotees. Grains cooked by non-devotees is not good to take because that will definitely have the karma. But roasted peanuts, you know, what to do, you know. Generally, we take them, you know. You get a packet of peanuts and they're roasted. You know, you may honor them. But we pray to Krishna, you know. Before taking them, we can offer to Krishna in our mind, think of Krishna and pray to Krishna that I'm taking these peanuts to satisfy myself. Please protect me. Don't let me get the karma. So ask Krishna to protect us.
Yes, Guru Maharaj. Actually, we get peanuts also sometimes in Indian shops. So the best thing is to take it and roast it, right, Guru Maharaj? If not for...
Yes. Yeah, best is if you can get, regular plain peanuts, and then you can cook them yourself.
So we should not take any bread, those things, because that are grains already.
Yes, bread is not very much recommended. Better if you can avoid the bread. If you need bread, then you can make your own bread. But much more healthier than bread is to take the roti, take the chapati. Yes. It's much healthier. Sir. Much healthier than taking
bread. Because most of the breads have egg also. Yes, everything has egg and even the chips packet. This has the label vegan. So we don't know it is vegetarian or not vegetarian. We have to carefully see it.
Yes. You have to be careful. These things have many chemicals. Not really healthy food. Junk food, we call it, you know. Snack food. It's all junk food. Chemicals. No nutrition. No value. Just simply for the tongue. The nice taste in the tongue. That's all. So try to be cautious what we eat, what we put in the mouth. It's very important what we put in the mouth. In China, they have a saying that disease comes from the mouth. Whatever you put there, if you're not careful what you put in, then you'll get sick. So we're very careful. Try to only take, that is controlling the tongue. You see, that is real sense control. We only allow the tongue to take the proper food, the prasad of Krishna. That's the highest control of the tongue.
Nitya Mataji, do you want to read this 2.62? Vyayato Vishayan Pumsa Sangat Teju Pajayate Sangat Sanjayate Kama Kama Trodo Abhijayate. Translation, while contemplating the objects of the senses, a person develops attachment for them, and thus from such attachment lust develops, and from lust anger arises. Purpose. One who is not Krishna conscious is subjected to material desires while contemplating the objects of senses. The senses require real engagement, and if they are not engaged in the transcendental loving service of the Lord, they will certainly seek engagement in the service of materialism. In the material world, everyone, including Lord Shiva and Lord Brahma, to say nothing of other demigods in the heavenly planets, is subjected to the influence of sense objects, and the only method to get out of this puzzle of material existence is to become Krishna conscious. Lord Shiva was deep in meditation, but when Parvati agitated him for sense pleasure, he agreed to the proposal, and as a result, Kartikeya was born. When Haridas Thakur was a young devotee of the Lord, he was similarly allured by the incarnation of Maya Devi, but Haridas easily passed the test because of his unalloyed devotion to Lord Krishna. As illustrated in the above mentioned verse of Sri Yamunacharya, a sincere devotee of the Lord shuns all material enjoyment due to his highest taste for spiritual enjoyment in the association of the Lord. That is the secret of success. One who is not therefore in Krishna consciousness, however powerful he may be in controlling the senses by artificial repression, is sure ultimately to fail, for the slightest thought of sense pleasure will agitate him to gratify his desire.
All right, so this is another description of the fall down, how the devotee falls down in the material world. When the senses are not properly engaged, then the mind wanders and we begin to think about enjoying something. So we contemplate the objects of the senses, right? Do you remember what do we mean with the objects of the senses? Who knows? What are the objects of the senses? What is being talked about? Kirtida, do you know? Kirtida, are you here? The objects of the senses. Nitya Kumaran, do you know Mataji?
Yes, Prabha Guru Maharaj. A speech is the object for the mouth, a sense of tongue. And seeing.
Sorry, I was the able to switch on my phone.
Yes, Nitya Kumaran speaking. Yeah, okay.
Yeah,
see. Yeah, the tongue will taste, right?
Yeah.
Speech, so taste is one taste of the speech. Objects. Yeah, right.
Right. And the seeing is for eyes.
Yeah, seeing, the sense of sight. Yeah.
Yeah, the feel is for the skin.
Touching, touch, feeling.
Touching skin, yeah.
Yeah.
And listening for the ears. And
hearing, yeah.
Yeah. And the sense of smell.
Right. So these are the objects. So but any one of these things can take away the mind, right? Any one thing. It may be sound, it may be sight, it may be smell, something, but somehow the object of the senses takes away the mind and we become attached to it. Oh, we become attached. Oh, this is very nice. Oh, I like this. Oh, what's that? Oh. The mind wanders and we become attached. And then after attachment, then next comes lust, right? First of all, the first stage is the attachment and then the lust. That I must have it. I want it very badly. Right? You want it. And then when you don't get it, then next comes anger. So stages of fall down. You'll see in the next verse also, four more stages of fall down going on from anger. What happens after anger? Anger is not the end. Then there's more further on. So we see also from here.
We lose our mind. Oh, yeah.
We see from here the relationship between lust and anger. That anger is like the younger brother of lust. Right? When we get angry, it comes when sometimes our lust is not satisfied. And because our lust was not satisfied, we become angry. So we often point out that anger is the younger brother of lust. Because we had some lust, some desire for something, we didn't get what we wanted, then we become angry. So we have to be very careful to guard against this. Therefore, it was described, we have to keep our senses always engaged in Krishna consciousness, using everything in the service of Krishna. So Haridas Thakur was chanting the holy name. When we chant, we use our hand to count on the beats, right? Our sense of touch is engaged. Use the fingers, we're counting on the beats. And we're using our tongue to chant the name. We're using our ears to hear the holy name. And we're using our mind to remember Krishna, to hear that holy name and to remember Krishna's qualities and pastimes. And we may chant also, we will chant Haridas Thakur. He used to chant in front of Tulsi. He kept a Tulsi plant and he would sit beside the Tulsi tree and chant. He didn't have deities. He just had Tulsi. And he'd sit and chant in front of the Tulsi. I remember one time Prabhupada came in New York. I was there at the time. And Prabhupada came to the temple and he said, he had a picture taken of him sitting with Tulsi. He said, this is all we need, Tulsi and the holy name. He said, you don't need a lot of deities and everything. Just the Tulsi tree and the holy name. And Haridas Thakur, he would do his japa like that, sitting beside Tulsi. So Tulsi is a very pure devotee, sacred tree. She takes her birth just to serve Krishna. So we can chant also in the presence of Tulsi, very powerful. Do you all keep Tulsi at home? Is it possible to keep Tulsi at home? Nitya yes, Kumaran,
I think you
must have Tulsi at home, don't
yes,
you?
Yes, yes. Yes, Guru Maharaj.
Yeah,
I have Tulsi plant.
Yes. Chennai, not a good climate there. It's a good climate for Tulsi.
Yeah, yeah.
We have many Tulsis growing here in Mayapur, all over. Tulsis everywhere. And by Prabhupada's mercy, Tulsi has become also popular all over the planet. She grows in America, even in countries where it's very cold, like Canada and Russia. You go to Russia, they also have Tulsi. Like Kirtida Mataji.
Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, I'm here.
Yes,
I have Tulsi tree.
Yeah, Kirtida is coming from very far east of Russia. So they keep Tulsi there, even though they have a very short summer and very long winter, very cold. Still they keep Tulsi and she grows. Because Tulsi grows with devotion. Okay. Any questions? You have to remember this relationship between lust and anger. We always have to control lust and anger. And the lust is coming. Where is it coming from? The lust is coming from attachment. We get so attached to something. We want something very bad, desire, right? So controlling the mind, very important. Don't become too much attached. But be attached to Krishna. Be attached to the holy name. That's spiritual attachment. That kind of attachment is good. Don't be attached to the body. Don't be attached to the temporary material world. Be attached to Krishna, Krishna's service. Keep herself always engaged like that. And be careful not to get too much absorbed in thinking of material things. Okay, we'll go ahead. Have we got time?
We should start chanting Guru Maharaj. It's 11:30 now.
Right, I think so. Yeah, right. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasade Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare.